Hello, Penn High School. Welcome back to another edition of PNN for May 10th, 2019. I'm Suli.
And I'm Riley Pratt. We hope you all had a great week. Now, let's get into the news and announcements.
Penn's academic Super Bowl teams won the state championship, taking first place in math, fine art, and interdisciplinary selections.
Great job, Kingsman. Sunday is the last day for the Debate T-shirt fundraiser, supporting their trip to Dallas. Their team of nine is the largest amount of people that Penn has sent to the national tournament in several years, and the chance to get new sponsorship allies is on the line. T-shirts and sweatshirts range from $10 to $23. For the T-shirt link, check out the full story on pnn.phmschools.org.
Now to our sport anchor, Pat Whitehead.
Hello, Penn High School. I'm your sports anchor, Pat Whitehead, here to fill you in on how our spring sports teams have been doing in the last week. To start off, the boys golf team competed in the prestigious Florence Choger event at Knollwood Country Club. They won the invite, beating St. Joe and Riley. Baz Ferry shot a 74 and Josh Yoder shot a 78. Congratulations to the boys golf team for winning the Choger invite. Penn girls tennis team attempted to make up their match against John Adams, but the rains came again, raining them out for the fourth time in a row. And Wednesday night, the girls' tennis team faced Marion on senior night. The boys' track team competed in the Valparaiso Relays at Valparaiso High School. The boys finished in second place, 273 points. Colin Mott won the 300-meter hurdles and took the third in the 100-meter hurdles. Caden Paquette finished first in the discus, and Vishal Turner finished second. The 4x800-meter relay team won due to the efforts of Dylan Potschmidt, Ricky Chappell, Seth Janikowski, and Avery Richardson. Seth Janikowski and Dylan Potschmidt both ran PR splits. Alec Hardrick finished first place in the freshman-sophomore 100 race. The softball team traveled to Oak Park River Forest on Saturday, May 4th for a doubleheader. They beat the Illinois powerhouse 12-6 in the first game. Tori Budzinski had three hits, including two home runs, and drove in two runs. Mackenzie Griman had two home runs and a double, and had seven RBIs. The Kingsmen swept the doubleheader, winning 9-3 in the second game. Brenda Brown had a single home run and a single, and she drove in two runs. Eddie Coys had two hits and two RBIs. The boys' rugby team won the Midwest Championship on Saturday, May 5th. They beat Royal Irish 21-17, the Kingsmen rallied back from a 12-0 deficit. Brandon Thomas, Johnny Ho, and Patrick Macklin all scored one try. Cian Messer made three conversion kicks. The girls' track traveled to Mishawaka last night for their NIC meet. The Lady Kingsmen finished in second place behind the Mishawaka Cavemen with a score of 139.5. Freshman Julie Smith won a blue ribbon in the 800 with a time of 20 minutes, 24 seconds. Next up, the baseball team competed in the Plymouth tournament. The Kingsmen beat Hamilton Southeastern 8-4 in the first game of the day, advancing to the championship. Cameron Koch and Kyle Klein both had two hits and drove in two home runs. Adam Hummel also had one hit and two RBIs. The boys played Fort Wayne Carroll in the championship, winning 7-3. Ryan Lynch had two RBIs and two hits. CJ Davis and Brock Boynton each had two hits, and Cameron Koch had two more RBIs. Keegan Hoskins pitched a two scoreless inning to close the game, striking out four. Congratulations to Cameron Koch, Ryan Lynch, Brock Boynton, and CJ Davis for earning all tournament honors, and to the entire baseball team for winning their Plymouth tournament. The varsity boys baseball team took on South Bend, Washington on the road. Penn won with a score of 15-2, finishing in five innings. Zach Pixley pitched a complete game on giving up two hits, along with two walks. Senior Brendan Danaway racked three runs and two RBI. Kyle Klein finished with two hits, including a double and three RBI. Girls lacrosse welcomed the Cathedral Royal Irish on May 6th. Penn took the win 17-3, improving to 15-2 on the season, as well as number two in the state. Madison Ash contributed with 2 assists. Carson Barna, Sequoia DeLue, Isabella Montgomery, Neely Reyes, and Alyssa Lundy each had 1 assist as well. Goalie Jocelyn Kirkpatrick helped out with 8 assists. The girls lacrosse next game is tomorrow, May 9th, as they will travel to Portage, Michigan to take on Portage Northern. Boys lacrosse hosted their senior night on Tuesday, May 7th. The boys played against Northridge High School. The game started slow, with the first goal happening 5 minutes in their first quarter. Overall, the Penn Kingsmen beat the Northridge Raiders. The ending score was 15-7. Many goals came from junior Tyler Laley and senior Jackson Lambert. The boys' next game is tonight, Friday, May 10th. That's all the news and sports I have for you today, Penn. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, Pat.
Dance Classic tickets go on sale May 16th for $5. Tickets will also be sold at the door on performance days May 23rd and 24th, but they sell out fast, so be sure to get them now.
Also, prom is tomorrow night, May 11th from 8 p.m. to 12 a.m. One ticket costs $30, so be sure to buy them in advance.
Well, this looks like the end of our show, Penn. We leave you today with the sights and sounds of the Penn-Harris-Madison Bubble Bash from last Saturday. The race was a huge success with thousands in attendance and was hosted by the PHM Educational Foundation, which recently donated $18,510 in grant money to PHM staff members. For more information, you can head over to www.phmef.org.
For more stories, don't forget to check out our website at pnn.phmschools.org.
On May 4th, thousands of people gathered at Penn High School for some bubble-filled fun. There was a bubble run, vendors from around the community, health screenings, a silent auction, and a talent showcase. Schools alone brought in around $10,000 for the Penn-Harris Madison Education Foundation. The Bubble Bash run, which included running through bubbles, silly string, and chalk dust, attracted approximately 570 people and families, while the talent showcase brought in many students and their families. Superintendent Dr. Jerry Thacker says the Silver Mile is a showcase of talent and a showcase of collaboration and hard work. The Silver Mile being the biggest fundraiser of the year, it definitely pays off in many ways throughout the corporation. This is Madison Renbarger reporting for PNN.